I'm Anil Kumar. Here's a practice question for you to simplify polynomials. You need to combine the like terms and simplify the given polynomials. We have two examples. First one is 7x squared minus 5x minus 2 minus, within brackets, x squared minus x plus 3. The second one is 5x squared plus 3x minus 5 minus, within brackets, 3x squared plus 2x plus 1. You can pause the video, copy these questions, solve, and then look into my suggestion. Now, in these videos, we have taken minus sign here. Do you see that? So when there is a minus sign before the bracket, all the signs will change. So let's rewrite the polynomial without brackets. That is, let's open the bracket. So in the first case, this is positive. All terms remain exactly same. 7x squared minus 5x minus 2. Here, since it is minus, all the terms inside the brackets will have reversed signs. So this becomes minus x squared, minus minus is positive, so plus x, minus times plus is negative, minus 3. So now you get a polynomial with 6 terms, right? Let's combine the like terms. Before combining, let me write them together so that it becomes clear to you. So I brought minus x squared to the left side. Then we have minus 5x, like term is plus x. Numbers are minus 2 and minus 3. Let's combine x squared terms. X squared terms, 7x squared minus x squared is 6x squared. Minus 5x plus x is minus 4x. Minus 2 minus 3 is minus 5. So finally, we get a polynomial in which there are no like terms. So that is the simplest form of polynomial, right? Follow these steps, follow these steps and do the next one. Here is the solution for you. So we could open the brackets, 5x squared plus 3x minus 5. This is minus, all signs will change, minus 3x squared minus 2x minus 1. Bring the like terms together, 5x squared minus 3x squared, that is this. Then we have plus 3x minus 2x minus 5 minus 1. Combine the like terms, 5 minus 3 is 2, 2x squared, 3x minus 2x is x. Do not write 1x, just x is good enough. Never write 1 as a coefficient, okay? Minus 5 minus 1 is minus 6. That becomes our answer, right? That is how you should be doing it. I hope that helps. Thank you and all the best. In coming videos, we'll see how distributive property is applied and then polynomials will be simplified. Thank you.